Hello friends, today I'll talk about how to set up the DB2 SSL communication. So we have to do a couple of steps on the server and on the client. On the server, we have to create the local key store, the master key, set up the DB2COM variable to set up the support SSL, and then we have to update some of the DBM config parameters, the SSL SVR parameters, and start and stop the instance. And on the client, we have to update DBM config parameter, SSL client parameters, then start and stop the instance and catalog the node with SSL support. And the database has to be cataloged on this particular node. So the steps again, create the local key store using this particular command, kdb create db, then create the master key. And then you can use this particular command to see the list of the master key created, and then we set up the DB2COM to set support the SSL. What in this case what will happen is, because we have given SSL and TCP/IP, the communication will go via the SSL as well as TCP/IP. If we want to disable the TCP/IP, we just have to modify this particular variable and remove the TCP/IP. So we keep SSL and we remove this. So right, if you keep like this, then the TCP/IP communication will also happen, the SSL communication will also happen. If you keep like this, the only SSL communication will happen, which we will do in the end of this video. So right now, first we'll start with both, and then some of the parameter at the instance level. Again, these are the steps, five steps at the server. So we have to set up these parameters, kdb, stash, label, and the service. And this is the port where SSL communication will happen. So when we catalog the node, we will be using this particular port to communicate. And then start and stop the instance. And at the client level, we will be setting again some db config parameters, only two of them, the client kdb and client stash file, start and stop the instance. And then we catalog the node with the port which we set in the SSL service name, the 6001, and then we use the security SSL. This is the only thing that we add to the command TCP/IP node, and rest the catalog DB command is same. We can use the authentication server, but even if you don't mention it is fine, right? So let's start with the tutorial. So as always, I have my database version at 11.1. So this tutorial is at 11.1 fixed pack 4. So let me clear my screen, and I'll show you before how my DB2Set variable looks like. So that's TCP/IP and any of SSL parameters. None of the SSL parameters have been set, which means this particular instance is accepting normal TCP/IP communication. Now, what I'll do is, first I'll create, go to this particular location and show you if there are any files. This directory is empty. Using this, we'll create the DB, then we'll add this secret key, and then I'll list the secret key. So okay, so I have created, this is the secret key which has been added using this command. I can see, so the create DB, add the secret key, and list the secret key. So that's been done. Now what we'll do is, we will set the variable to say that, okay, so I've set the DB2COM variable to SSL. So now what I'll do is start and stop my instance. Okay, so what we got here is, looks like the DB2COM, the TCP/IP came up, the TCP/IP service came up, but the SSL did not come up. And that I can prove using nested minus an grep listen grep 000. So 5001, that's my port. Actually, it is 50001, but I just say 5001. So just ignore that. So 5001, that's the normal instance port, TCP/IP port, and the SSL port did not come up. This is the port for another instance. So what we'll do is, we will now configure the DBM config parameter, and we will specify this particular file. And along with this file, if you see, one stash file also got generated that we will use in this particular parameter. And we will say we want to use this particular port as SSL port. And then finally we'll start and stop the instance. And then once that is done, I will show you the DBM config parameters. And right now it is listening on 5001. So let's do this all together. Copy, paste, and okay. So if you see, I got the error message here. Where was that error message? Support for one or more communication protocols. So this is the error message when the DB2 start was done. So now when I did the DB2 start, I did not get that error message, which means all the protocols. And you see, I got this 6001 also listening, and this is my SSL port. Here I specified this SSL, and this is the SSL port, and that port also started listening. Previously I had only 5001 listening, now I have got 6001 also listening. So this is done at the client. So server level we are through, become these settings have been done. So let me close this and let me open one more session and log in to the client. Okay, so let me show you list node, nothing, list db, nothing. So what we'll do is we will catalog the that's done. So now I got two nodes. If you see here, so I got two nodes. One is the DB2P, which is using the TCP/IP, and DB2PS using the SSL. And you see here, I said the security type as SSL, which is not here. So this is the normal TCP/IP port. This is the TCP/IP port with the SSL communication. Now, if I show you here, I got this sample underscore yes, which is listening on DB2PS, and DB2PS is configured with the SSL communication. And then there is sample, which is communicated on DB2P, which is normal TCP/IP. So I got two database entries, one listening via TCP/IP, one listening via the SSL. So let's try communicating to the database. So let me activate my database here. And let me try to communicate to this particular database. Okay, looks like the connection went through. Actually, why did I do connect reset? So let's actually, yeah. So let me show here and clear the screen, and my connection came in. So, and if I try to see this particular communication, this particular communication 25637 has been established with 5001 port, and 5001 port is my TCP/IP port, not the 6001. So what I'll do now is I will try to go to sample underscore yes, and I got this error, which means something is missing. So my client, my server is ready with the 6000. If I show you what are the ports which are up, I got 5001, which is TCP/IP, and 6001, which is SSL port. Both ports are up, but I'm still not able to connect to the database on sample underscore S, which is on the node which is using SSL communication. The reason is I did not configure these two parameters, the SSL client KDB and stash parameters. And from where I'll get these particular files, I'll use the same file which I created on the server. So let me do one thing. Let me first copy those two files. And then let me, once I copied, update the, okay, so before updating DB2 DBM config grep SSL, I need to set these two parameters to the files, these particular files. Now I'll do that and start and stop my instance. And now I will try to connect to the SSL port. GSKit error 408 could not be loaded. Very nice. Okay, right. Let me see what exactly happened. Okay, so the permissions of these particular files are okay, it's a permission issue, so I need to fix this. So they are with the root, the db2s instance could not read these files. So sudo chown db2s/dba*, and let me do those three steps again. Right, so now you see the sample S which just failed here. If you see sample S, it failed with JSKit error, and now I am able to connect. And now if I go here and show you list app, I got this particular connection 50085. So let me see where is that connection. It has gone, so it has not gone to 5001, it has gone to 6001. And if I show you, my 6001 is my SSL port. So looks like I've been able to communicate to my server using the SSL port or SSL communication, and it looks like it is working because I have established the connection to 6001. So now I'll go back to the client, and what I'll do is like I will show you the connection to using the TCP/IP. So I'm connecting via TCP. This is the SSL communication and this is the non-SSL communication, and both is going. So this is also going and this is also going. So both connections are working. I don't want the TCP/IP at all on the server. So what I'm going to do is before setting that, I'll just show you what is db2set minus all. So I got this as SSL and TCP/IP. I'll just set this to SSL. So which means that TCP/IP communication won't happen. So let me do that and activate my sample database once that is done. Okay, now I'll run the same commands again. Clear. My SSL communication is happening. Look good. My TCP/IP communication is not happening, which means the server is only configured for SSL communication. That it won't accept the TCP/IP communication at all. The reason is pretty simple. We have removed this variable, the TCP/IP, from the db2.com, and it only says SSL. So this was a short tutorial. I hope it was useful. You may not face this situation. You may have to do this very rarely, but if you ever have to do, and if you struggle, these are the things that you need to do. You create a local key store, you create a master key, you set up the db2.com variable to support SSL, you set up some of the DBM config parameters, and you start and stop the instance. That's on the server. And on the client, you configure the SSL client, not the SSL server, and start and stop the instance and catalog the node. And when you catalog the node, you use the security as SSL. So, and you will use this particular port, which is the SSL service name. So this particular port that we configured using. So I hope this tutorial was useful. It is pretty simple to configure. May this tutorial find useful in your career. Thanks for watching. Bye bye, and see you in next video. Thank you.